Arthur. Hi, Arthur.
Hey. So that feller who's hassling you and Valentine.
I'll tell you another time, okay?
Okay, sure. Okay, I'll catch you later then.
Okay.
All right, go on. It ain't like you got balls anyways.
Lincoln shot.
Oh, hell's half.
At least that's what they told me. The modern world is ugly. But the old world was worse. Our job.
All right, boy. Have this, boy. Let's get you looking nice.
This one. Sorry.
I feel terrible.
Lord have mercy!
Hey! Need a hand with your horse? Shit.
Hey there, mister.
Hello. Darn people.
Thank you.
Yeah. Easy, easy. That's it. Hey, boy. Mister.
Stay back from the wagon, sir. Transporting a fugitive.
Slow up now.
Interesting way of putting it, Seamus.
No doubt. I do interesting very well. It's trusting I don't do so well.
Please. I know how to work with good people, Seamus, and I work in the right way.
They all say that. I never met an idiot that called himself one.
Very true. In that case, I'm an idiot. But I know how to get things done efficiently. Look at me. Why would I lie about this? Partner, this is Seamus. He's our new partner.
I ain't no such thing.
Prospective new partner, if he likes us.
Liking ain't the problem. Trusting is, as I said. Keep your voices down. I don't want my boss hearing. This is a sideline.
Of course. Look at us. Honest as the day is long.
Exactly.
I'll tell you what. Let us prove ourselves.
Prove ourselves? To this clown? What you talking about?
Good day, Hosea. Good luck with your business dealings.
Listen. He's rough and ready and quick with his tongue, but I swear you can trust him and trust me.
I'm an old man.
You're not old, Seamus.
I'm old enough. And you know why I ain't dead?
You don't trust idiots.
Exactly.
We're not idiots. Let us prove it to you.
Okay. I'll tell you what.
Arthur.
Old Bob Crawford and his boys just bought a beautiful stolen stagecoach from upstate. It's in their barn. Now you go get that, and then we can work together.
Who's old Bob Crawford?
An acquaintance of mine.
So you want us to take out your competition?
Well, he's not just an acquaintance, but a cousin by marriage. I also want to see if you boys got what it takes. Now, you survive that.
Where is he?
Well, he's in a farmhouse just northwest of here called Carmody Dell. It's just up the train tracks as you're heading up towards Fort Wallace. There's also some money in that house, but that's your business, not mine. But don't kill nobody. Folks know we ain't intimate no more, and they'll know it was me.
But you're fine with us robbing your cousin.
By marriage. And yes, I'd love it.
You heard the man. Let's go rob his cousin.
By marriage.
Let's just get it over with.
Really?
Really. Lead the way. He said the place is just northwest of here.
Me?
You're the one who's been out gallivanting around here.
That's what you call it. Well, clearly you've recovered from your bear encounter.
That better, couldn't you?
Thought you wanted me here to show some strong arm. That's usually how it goes.
Yes, but you know how this works.
Come on, Hosea. That feller's a joke.
And that's why he's perfect. He won't cause us any problems. A safe spot to fence wagons and coaches, that's easy money for us.
I guess you're right.
Come on, it's not like he's asking us to rob a bank. If the two of us can't steal a stagecoach from Seamus's old crooked cousin by marriage, we should hang up our hats now. Huh.
So, what's the story with that Emerald Ranch? You find out anything else?
A little. Owner's a nasty type, by all accounts. Seamus is sure scared of him.
That's not saying much.
Something strange about the place. Used to be a saloon there, general store. Now it's all closed up, but they seem to have money.
Sounds worth a look around.
For sure. Seamus also mentioned the rancher's daughter a couple of times. How he used to see her around all the time, but now she never leaves the house? Probably just sweet on her.
That would... Did you call finding out a little?
Once he opens up, seems Seamus does like to talk.
Hopefully not too much.
That must be the place up ahead. We should go on foot from here. Let's see what we're dealing with. Come on. There's the house. I see the barn in the back. Stagecoach has to be in there.
Okay, let's take a quick look at the place.
Anyone around?
Yes. Okay. I reckon we can do it now. I'll head over, distract him by putting on a little show while you sneak into the house, find what you can, then get the stagecoach. Or wait until nightfall. Sneak in, then I'll get the coach. You can try the house. What do you think?
Let's wait.
Okay, let's go.
Sure.
You go into the house. I'll go find this wagon.
Maybe take a peek through the windows before you go in. Make sure it's all quiet. Get on, dear boy. Come on, get on and let's head back. Everything we needed.
And I'm pretty sure they never even knew I was there.
Best way. Less problems, the better right now. Just need to get this back to Seamus in one piece, and it's a good night's work. So what were you able to lift from the house?
A few bits and pieces. Nothing too fancy.
Well, we need anything we can get right now.
This was easier than hunting a 1,000-pound grizzly anyway.
No doubt. I won't forget that in a hurry.
I'm looking forward to your retelling of that one around the campfire.
It wasn't the first time Mr. Matthews had stared death in the eye. And as usual, he did not flinch.
Exactly. Stick around here for?
You sure this is the way? Not sure. Till we can't, I suppose. Feels like we're starting to get back on our feet. Slowly but surely. Just need to keep at it. Dutch has a new money chest stashed in a safe spot away from camp, but it's a long way from being full.
I hope it's not stashed in town like we did in Blackwater. Even if we had to dump the money from the ferry. We could have at least got the rest out if it was hidden someplace else.
No, I think we've learned our lesson there. And a few other lessons besides.
I hope so, but I ain't so sure about that.
Here's something strange. Seamus was telling me how he also makes these little trinkets for people from animal claws, teeth, and such like. Good luck charms.
What, like a rabbit's foot?
Okay, here we are. Just pull the coach into the barn there. Hello, Seamus. We met your cousins.
How was it?
Fine. Nice people.
Park that thing in here. Quickly.
Nice work, Hosea.
It was mostly Arthur. Like I said, coarse but competent.
Here.
Thank you.
If you find any other coaches that need selling, I'll see what I can offer you for them. But discreet, you know.
Of course.
Goodbye, gentlemen.
I'm heading back to camp, I think. You coming?
Sure.
Thank you.
It was a heap of trouble, but I got Mike out of jail.
Oh, thank you, Arthur. So where is he?
Still out around that way, looking for a peace offering and shit. All right, well, I should be getting on.
Okay.
One minute that you ever made it to Australia.
Well, man, you'd be right.
I never did, but I tried. I made it as far as Chicago. Chicago ain't nowhere near Australia.
No, but it's on the way.
I always wanted to see one of them kangaroos. Giant boxing rats who keep their babies in their pockets.
That's an interesting way of seeing things.
Maybe we'll head over there one of these days, huh? Yeah. Start a new life.
You'll work it out, Dutch. You always do.
Good morning, Arthur.
Hey, get up.
Huh, what?
Good morning.
Morning, mister.
Eat this, boy. Yeah. Okay there, boy. Mm-hmm. There you go. Easy, boy. Okay, feller.
Okay there? Let's go, boy.
If the dirt weren't bad enough, darn livestock shitting up the place, too.
That's just how it is.
Well, anyway.
Morning, friend.
Hey there!
Waltzing through here like you own the place. But the O'Driscoll's got designs on it.
Morning. Hey, mister.
Let's get you cleaned up. Yeah, you all right there, boy?
Yes?
Oh, I'm sorry I didn't mean to disturb you, ma'am. Is Mrs. Linton in?
I'll go see.
Mrs. Linton, a caller for you.
Hello, Arthur.
Mary?
I heard you and your friends was around.
Okay. Where's what's his name?
Died.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah, me too. Me too. Happened a while ago. Pneumonia.
Bad business.
Sure.
So, you've been... you've been made a widow and you come here looking for me, is that it?
No, ain't like that, Arthur.
Ah, okay.
Listen, Arthur, I'm... my family. I need your help.
You mean the family that always looked down on me? You want me to help?
It's my little brother, Jamie.
I always liked Jamie, at least compared to the rest of them.
He's broken Daddy's heart.
Daddy has a heart?
Don't make me beg you, Arthur.
My money, my life, me. I wasn't good enough.
I'm sorry. We need your help real bad. Little Jamie joined the Chelonians, that strange religious order.
Good for him.
They're quite mad, Arthur. They'll kill him. You're the only person he'd listen to.
So, I'm too rough to marry into your family, but it's okay to ask me to help in saving your family.
I'm sorry. I understand if you don't want to help me, but I think of you often.
Long time ago now.
I'm begging you, Arthur.
I say let Jamie live Jamie's life and not the nightmare that his daddy dreamed up for him.
Jamie's so innocent, Arthur. Please, Arthur. Will you help me?
Where is it?
Somewhere out near Carmody Dell, I think. The rancher there said he'd seen him around the Cumberland Forest. I just want him back. Arthur, if you find him, bring him to me at the station.
I'll see what I can do.
I'll owe you.
You already owe me. That's my boy. Let's lighten the load here, boy. Thank you. Yeah. Yeah. Easy, whoa. Come on, pal.
Please help me out of here. Thank the Lord you showed up when you did. All the things he said he'd do to me.
It's all right, ma'am. It's over now.
Plenty of road to spare. Suggest you use it.
Howdy. Nice folks around here. That's a strong-looking horse. Easy. Easy there. Thank you.
much game is barely worth cooking.
It ain't a competition, friend.
And rediscovery of theology. 100 years ago.
Gentlemen! Can I speak to the boy?
Arthur?
Hello, son. Your sister is very worried.
The boy has chosen a path, sir. The path to truth.
Well, his sister just wants to speak with him.
Arthur, I've chosen a path.
The boy has chosen a path. He's chosen safety. What path have you chosen, sir? So, do you have an answer?
I don't know about this nonsense. Let me speak to the boy.
Dut-dut. Are you always this negative and antagonistic, sir?
I'm not a very cultured man. Forgive me, please.
I am a fool for my God and a happy one, sir. I bless you. What do I dream about? Who are my heroes?
I have no idea. Turtles. Yeah, turtles. Hey, you love turtles? I love them too. Turtles.
Jamie knows the truth. But of course, you may speak with him.
Exactly. If your teachings are so great, what harm can I do?
I'm not coming with you, Arthur!
Just come and speak with Mary, then make up your mind!
Leave me alone, Arthur! I didn't ask for your help! Leave me alone, Arthur! I didn't ask for your help!
Christ's sakes, Jamie! Just hold up a minute!
I was doing just fine by myself! Sorry!
They're just using you! Telling you what you want to hear!
What the hell do you know about it, Arthur?
Let's talk about this!
This is none of your damn business!
Damn it, we gotta do this the hard way!
I don't have to answer to you!
Come on, you ain't stupid! You can see this is crazy!
You're the crazy one!
Jamie, your sister's worried about you.
You pop up out of nowhere?
Whoa, you little jackass.
Sorry, mister.
What are you gonna do, Jamie? Live the rest of your life in the mountains with those people?
They're my friends. If you don't leave me alone, I'll shoot you. I swear it.
What are you talking about? You ain't no killer.
You don't know who I am.
You got more, boy. Come on.
Chelonia. Leave me alone, Arthur! I didn't ask for your help!
Just stop! Let's talk about this!
I was doing just fine by myself! Sorry!
They're just using you! Telling you what you want to hear! Sister's worried about you.
I don't have to answer to you.
Yeah. Damn it, we gotta do this the hard way.
This is none of your damn business.
Jamie, just hold up a minute. Come on, you ain't stupid. You can see this is crazy.
You're the crazy one. You pop up out of nowhere?
Yeah.
rest of your life in the mountains with those people?
They're my friends! If you don't leave me alone, I'll shoot you! I swear it!
What are you talking about? You ain't no killer!
You don't know who I am! I'm a man now. I found something. A calling.
You're just a kid. You're making a big mistake.
I'm not taking advice from you. You're an outlaw. You leave me alone. They're good people. I'm warning you, Arthur Morgan. Leave me alone.
Please, kid. Put that gun down.
I warn you, Arthur! I'm gonna... I don't want to live anymore!
Kid, just calm down.
Leave me alone! I warn you, Arthur! I'm gonna... I don't want to live anymore!
Kid, just calm down.
Leave me alone!
Now calm down! Let's go see your sister.
Okay. Okay.
Okay, kid.
Have I been a terrible fool, Arthur?
I don't know. I don't know enough about it. But one thing I do know, there ain't no shame in looking for a better world.
I missed you, Arthur. Are you and Mary sweet on one another again?
Oh, no. That's all a long time ago, son.
Well, this wasn't how I thought today would turn out.
It's been a long... long time, Jamie Gillis. You were a kid last time I saw you. And didn't try to kill yourself.
You know, you taught me how to ride a horse.
Too well, apparently. Shalonia, though? Really? You'd fall for that?
They were very nice to me. They're decent.
I'm sure. Please tell me you didn't give them any money.
Of course I did. They rely on charitable donations.
Jesus, Jamie, come on.
I just wanted to believe that there might be something good coming my way one day. Guess that's dead in the water.
With the turtles.
Shut up. All Father kept telling me was, you won't amount to anything. You're not enough of a man. I had to get away. I couldn't take it anymore.
Forgive me, but your father's a bully and a coward. Don't listen.
Hey, don't talk about him like that.
What do you want me to say, Jamie? He's a good father, nice man.
He won't be happy I saw you.
Please send him my worst regards.
Thing is, he's right. I'm not good at anything.
Come on, that ain't true. Tell me something you like. Don't think too hard.
Apples, I guess.
Apples?
Yeah, I love apples.
Okay. I was thinking more along the lines of carpentry or horses or something. All right, go work in an orchard then.
By that token, you must really like shooting and robbing people.
I only like shooting young idiots who run away from me when I'm trying to help them.
Father told me what you do.
I'm sure he did.
Are you still with Dutch and... what was his name? Hester?
Jose. Yep, still the same, sort of.
And Annabelle and Bessie?
I'm afraid they're dead.
Shit. Maybe Mary did make the right choice.
No doubt. But none of it is anything like the nonsense you read in the newspapers.
So, are you two getting back together?
I told you, no. Just ask me for a favor.
You know Barry Lyndon's dead? Pneumonia.
She told me.
So the door's open, so to speak.
That's all in the past. Different people now. Here we are. She must be waiting inside.
Make it quick or I might run off again.
Hey, mister.
You're nervous about seeing her, aren't you?
You okay, boy? Come here.
Father's been very sad.
Father wouldn't know sadness if it died in his bed. But I'll come home for you.
My boy. My sweet boy. Come on. Oh, Arthur. Thank you. Thank you.
It's good to see you, Mary.
And you, Arthur. And you. Oh, you'll never change. I know that.
I feel like the luckiest man alive, and I feel like a fool. That woman confuses me and plays me for a fiddle like no one else alive. I trust I will not make a god-awful fool of myself once more, but somehow I imagine I shall.
The last thing we need is more trouble from you.
okay?